Senior, how many days have passed since the 31st of December, 1999?
10,636.
10,000 days. It's the blink of an eye. And I thought, there we are. We've done it. Nice little world. And that's all it took. 10,000 days.
Secretary Cheney and I are honored and humbled to have won the state of Florida, which gives us the needed electoral votes to win the election. We will therefore undertake the responsibility of preparing to serve as America's next president and vice president.
We're looking at the World Trade Center. We understand that a plane has crashed into the World Trade Center.
It is perpetrated by fanatics who are utterly indifferent to the sanctity of human life. And we, the democracies of this world, are going to have to come together to fight it together and eradicate this evil completely from our world.
To Edinburgh now, where 100,000 people are partying in the streets.
For 300 million Europeans, from grocery shoppers in France to bankers in Germany, today was the first workday for their new common currency, the euro.
On Tuesday night, I gave the order for British forces to take part in military action in Iraq. Tonight, British servicemen and women are engaged from air, land and sea. Their mission? To remove Saddam Hussein from power and disarm Iraq of its weapons of mass destruction.
Thank you to every single person that's here today in the biggest ever political demonstration in the history of this country. Everybody in the world has a chance today to say no, absolutely no, to war on Iraq.
It has already been an exceptional summer, but today temperatures soared higher than ever before. Each passing day of this heat wave has made record temperatures more likely.
Now, millions of students use the Facebook.com to list not only their pictures and hobbies, but as a virtual community.
The voters turned out in record numbers and delivered an historic victory.
And that's pretty much all there is to say.
Across the very heart of London, there was shock, confusion, and an almost palpable sense of fear among those caught up. This was the scene captured by a passerby less than a minute after the explosion.
There will, of course, now be the most intense police and security service action to make sure that we bring those responsible to justice.
Ronya Close and Shannon Sickles got engaged 3 years ago, and they've waited until today to become the first civil partners in the UK.
We just want to say that this is a very privileged position we're in this morning. And for us, this is about making a choice to have our rights, our civil rights, acknowledged and respected and protected as any human being.
As news of Saddam Hussein's execution spreads across the globe, reactions within Iraq are mixed. Many Iraqis watch the execution on television.
I've just accepted the invitation of Her Majesty the Queen to form a government. This will be a new government with new priorities. And I've been privileged to have been granted the great opportunity to serve my country.
And we are calling it iPhone. Today Apple is going to reinvent the phone.
We're now just weeks from the ban on lighting up in public places, but there's still doubt about exactly which public places will be affected.
This is our moment. This is our time to put our people back to work and open doors of opportunity for our kids, to restore prosperity and promote the cause of peace, to reclaim the American dream and reaffirm that fundamental truth that out of many we are one, that while we breathe, we hope, and where we are met with cynicism and doubt and those who tell us that we can't, we will respond with that timeless creed that sums up the spirit of a people. Yes, we can.
Thank you. God bless you. And may God bless the United States of America.
The British economy is falling off a cliff. That's how analysts are describing the situation at the moment. On a day when government data has confirmed that the British economy has officially entered recession.
Every family in this country, the stability of the banking system matters. So if families are going to have mortgages, if families are going to be able to access cash, if businesses are able to invest, they need a banking system that is sound.
The key thing now is what happens in Iceland, and all day the volcano has kept on erupting.
I woke up this morning and my cup is covered in this fine grey talcum-like powder.
With the outcome of the general election, we find ourselves in a position unknown to this generation of political leaders. With no single party able to have a Commons majority and therefore have a majority government.
A new government, and I have accepted. Our country has a hung parliament where no party has an overall majority, and we have some deep and pressing problems. A huge deficit, deep social problems, and a political system in need of reform. For those reasons, I aim to form a proper and full coalition between the Conservatives and the Liberal Democrats.
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda, and a terrorist who's responsible for the murder of thousands of innocent men, women, and children.
Greece is the latest European economy to be on life support. A decade of frantic overspending has left it roughly $400 billion in debt.
Thousands have turned out to witness the Diamond Jubilee pageant, the biggest spectacle on the Thames for over 300 years.
You know, I just don't think that everybody in the country thought at the time, or thinks now, the 1960s were the beginning of civilization, that rap music was a particularly good demonstration of British culture, or that in general it reflected the way they felt about their country. Certainly having myself a rather chilly, windswept, austere Protestant monocultural view of Britain, I didn't find it particularly appealing.
But
and the other thing I felt was
1960s?
I was very much under pressure to say that I liked it. Mm. And when I said that I didn't, people didn't say, oh, we disagree with you, let's argue about this. They said, oh, it's really shocking.
The eyes to the right, 400. The nose to the left, 175. So the eyes have it, the eyes have it.
Legally. Scottish voters have rejected independence, deciding to remain part of the United Kingdom. It was a historic referendum that shook the country to its core.
So now it is time for our United Kingdom to come together and to move forward. A vital part of that will be a balanced settlement, fair to people in Scotland, and importantly, to everyone in England, Wales, and Northern Ireland as well. I've just been to see Her Majesty the Queen, and I will now form a majority Conservative government. I've been proud to lead the first coalition government in 70 years, and I want to thank all those who worked so hard to make it a success.
Jeremy Corbyn, 251,000.
Our party has changed. We've grown enormously. We've grown enormously because of the hopes of so many ordinary people for a different Britain, a better Britain, a more equal Britain, a more decent Britain. They're fed up with the inequality, the injustice, the unnecessary poverty.
Inevitably, a long life can pass by many milestones. My own is no exception. But I thank you all, and the many others at home and overseas, for your touching messages of great kindness.
The week in which a bunch of loser jihadists slaughtered 132 innocents in Paris to prove the future belongs to them.
We are approaching one of the biggest decisions this country will face in our lifetimes, whether to remain in a reformed European Union or to leave. The choice goes to the heart of the kind of country we want to be and the future that we want for our children.
The official results are in. The people of Britain have spoken, voting for a British exit, dubbed Brexit, with almost 52% of the votes choosing to leave the 28-member European Union.
Let June the 23rd go down in our history as our Independence Day!
I will do everything I can as Prime Minister to steady the ship over the coming weeks and months. But I do not think it would be right for me to try to be the captain that steers our country to its next destination.
I have just been to Buckingham Palace, where Her Majesty the Queen has asked me to form a new government, and I accepted.
Received a call from Secretary Clinton. She congratulated us. It's about us.
I have just chaired a meeting of the Cabinet, where we agreed that the government should call a general election to be held on the 8th of June.
I welcome the opportunity for us to put the case to the people of Britain to stand up against this government and its failed economic agenda, which has left our NHS in problems, which has left our schools underfunded, which has left so many people uncertain.
What did Theresa May actually deliver in calling this election a dissipation of her majority? The Conservatives losing 12 seats from where they stood, Labour gaining 30.
What the country needs more than ever is certainty. And having secured the largest number of votes and the greatest number of seats in the general election, it is clear that only the Conservative and Unionist Party has the legitimacy and ability to provide that certainty by commanding a majority in the House of Commons.
Grenfell Tower was home to as many as 600 residents. Some of them had repeatedly raised concerns about fire safety in this block in recent years.
Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
And if a few children can get headlines all over the world just by not going to school, then imagine what we could all do together if we really wanted to.
Eyes to the right, 286. The nose to the left, 344. So the noes have it, the noes have it. Unlock!
The second female Prime Minister, but certainly not the last. I do so with no ill will, but with enormous and enduring gratitude to have had the opportunity to serve the country I love.
So yes, it's our fault. This is the world we built. Congratulations. Cheers, all.